Hi, this is Alfred speaking. I would be demonstrating the Fitzroy Catholic Bookstore website. So this is my homepage. And this is my catalog maintenance page. So these are all my fields. ISBN number, title, category, author, publisher name, etc. So I'll be demonstrating the validation scenarios when the user doesn't enter any kind of data. We get all the necessary validation messages below. And if we try to enter a negative value for price as well as for quantity, we again get the validation message below for that. Price value should be positive, quantity value should be positive. So these are my validation scenarios. So now I'll be demonstrating a successful scenario. Title would be the Ten Commandments. Category will be book. Author name will be James. Publisher will be Catholic Edition. ISBN 121. Title is 10 Commandments. Category is book. Author is J.K. Rowling. Publisher is Springer Edition. Price is $45. Quantity is less than 5. Trying to upload an image now using this control. There are two images here. I have uploaded capture.png image. Try to submit it. You see a message saved successfully. Go to the category search page. As you can see, I am able to see the number of products that has been displayed. That is, one product has been displayed. I'm able to see all the title name, category name, ISBN number, author name, edition, etc. So here are my search parameters. That is, the category is one parameter, price is another parameter, publisher name is another parameter. So we have the lower range and the higher range. Now I will be demonstrating the search functionality. If I enter the price value between $1 to $5, I won't be able to look for the book because my price of my book was $45. So again, if I search between $1 to $10,000, I'll be able. So I'll be adding one more product now. And one more thing, as you can see, the quantity is less than 5. As per our business requirement, if the quantity is less than 5, we should highlight that particular book. I have highlighted this book with yellow color. I'll add another book. ISBN 122, title is Jim Reeves, category is music, there is James, publisher is Catholic Edition, price is 78. Quantity is 10. When upload of the image, you can see, click on save successfully. You can see a message called save successfully. So if I go to the back to the catalog search page, I'll be able to see another product that has been displayed, which I've added. So the quantity is greater than 5, that's why this particular div has not been highlighted. And you can do a search based on the category name. If I select book, and if I do a search, then I will be able to get a book of that particular category, book. If I select music, let's click on submit, I'll be able to search the product whose category name is music. Similarly, for publisher name, Veselec Springer Edition, I'll be able to see Springer books under Springer Edition. As well as for price, if I select between $1 to $5, I won't be able to see any book. If I again try to do a search between $1 to $10,000, I'll be able to see both the books, because the price range comes below between these two ranges. Another functionality would be, now you can see the count of the products that are being displayed as per a business requirement. Also, if we try to do a mobile view of this product, if I try to squeeze this screen, you're still able to display this website in mobile view without any problem. Display has not been impacted. I'll quickly demonstrate the code which I've done. So this is the catalog maintenance page. Just show you the code. So I've created a user-defined function called isValid, which will do all the necessary validation for me. That is ISBN number, title, category, and it will store that value, the message value, inside a variable called validation message. Similarly, there is a validation done for the price details to check whether it is not less than zero, as well as for the quantity details to check whether it is not less than zero. And here is a code that will upload my file to my local application directory. As you can see, this form, I'm getting the form object of the HTML image type control and storing inside this variable called file item. Then I am retrieving the file name from here. And afterwards, after retrieving the file name using os.path.basename, I'm opening the directory of my local application directory, and IMGA is the folder which is there in my local application directory. I will concatenating the file name with this particular directory name, and I'm just writing this file using file item dot file dot read. So this enables me to write my file into my local application, and this function is responsible for writing the data inside my notepad file. This will open the notepad file and it will start appending the items, each of the variables that I've retrieved from the form. That is ISBN number, title, category, and the separator I've used is a single forward slash, sorry, not a forward slash, it's an hyphen that's been used for concatenating the values. These are the messages that I'm displaying. Just saved successfully, and I'm giving a green color. And if it is an error, then that particular text will display in red color. So basically, the concept here I've used is string.format. What the string.format does is it tries to replace the value stored inside this curly braces. So I have a variable which contains my entire HTML file. So this variable will swap with the first parameter. Suppose format isValid is a function that will be of the first index. That is 0, 1, 2. So this print statement will use a Python function, string function of format, and it will start replacing these values accordingly. So if the file gets saved successfully with the correct data, the message color would be green color, and the label will be of the inline type. The style of the label will be of inline type, and the message displayed would be saved successfully. And this isValid function will give me the messages based on the various conditions. If it is empty, and if the value is less than zero. So this is my catalog maintenance page. This is the HTML file. Main thing was saving the file, image file, inside a local application directory using OS library of Python. Okay, now I'll explain the code of the product search page. So this is my notepad file which contains the product search page. So this is a function that will read the products from my file. So it will look for that file name in the local application directory. Then it will start reading the file line by line. And it will start appending all the data from the file inside a catalog list, that is an array list. And this search function which I have defined, here are all my search parameters like that, such as category name, lower range of the price, higher range of the price, and the publisher name. And this function will retrieve the list of the data inside the notepad file into the Python array list, which is the catalog. And each of these conditions, it will check whether it is not equal to empty, whether it's not equal to none. And based on that, each of the items have been looped using for loop inside this catalog list array list. And it will again start checking the condition. If the value that is passed from the user by the user matches the value in the notepad file, so based on this array index, it will start matching the items based on publisher name, price, lower range, the item in the notepad file falls between the lower range and the higher range. If it matches the search criteria, this search result, which is again an array list, will be appended with the item from the notepad file. So each time, all these condition, LF condition, will check whether it is not equal to -1 and not equal to empty. So each of these scenarios will be tested, and all the NK scenarios will be tested, and if it is matching the criteria, the search list will append with the item from the notepad file. Finally, after doing the entire search list, this search results is the final array list which will contain the matched item based on the selected search criteria. So this search results, we will use it over here, we'll call this function over here. And once when the user presses the submit button from this page, and after selecting all these radio buttons and the text box value, it will go inside the search function, and this search function will again return as an array list which I was explaining before, which will contain the matched criteria from the search parameters. And again it will be loaded inside this particular product catalog list, and this list is used in various places. This is used for getting the count which we see in the search result page, as you can see this products. Mainly I've used the concept of string.format. Format is a function which replaces the values which are stored inside the curly braces. So these values are again, which you are seeing in this left hand side, is again looped from the search results array list, and all the category values are loaded from the notepad file. So these values are loaded dynamically from the notepad file. So this function, if you can see, it will get all the publisher details. This function will get the category details. That's all. And the main code is how the looping happens. Just show you how the looping happens. How this div is loaded dynamically from the notepad file. As you can see, this for each loop which I have written, this will contain the product table, that is the div table that you are which you are seeing in the right hand side of this page. This will start, this will contain all the HTML code for the particular div, and it will start loading the values one by one. And these values, these formatted values, will get replaced with the using the concept of string.format. It will start replacing the values accordingly wherever we have passed this. So the value of 0 will get replaced with the value of 0. Yeah, it will replace with this. The first item in this format function will get replaced with the second one. So that's how the div is loaded. Now, secondly, as you can see, this highlight, I've used JavaScript, that is that will highlight me the div whose quantity is less than 5. So there's a JavaScript jQuery function that I've written here. I've just looped against that particular div and searched for a div whose quantity is less than 5. And using jQuery, I have set the text such as stock limited. So if the quantity is less than 5, you will be able to display the color red, and you will be able to see the div color is yellow color. So this code is responsible for highlighting my div, that is my particular div inside a particular panel, to yellow color if the quantity is less than 5. And using the concept of Bootstrap, my particular website can be displayed even in mobile view. So that's all from me. Thank you very much.